This works so well that I can now actually kill people, or pretty much kill people, in Battlefield 1 on Xbox Cloud Gaming. That doesn't make you invincible though. Hey everyone and welcome to the Cloud Gaming Xtreme channel. Today I'm going to show you how you can use your mouse and keyboard to play Xbox Cloud Gaming. You can see I'm using the Xbox PC app with the Cloud Gaming tab and I'm using my keyboard and mouse to navigate around there. So I'm going to show you a bit of in-game just to have a talk about how well this works. Now you will need to have a fiddle with your sensitivity both on your mouse and the in-game control sticks to get the best matchup here. I'm just using the default settings here just to show you the default interaction. There was a minor amount of input delay and this is what I mean by you need to tweak your settings. Because my mouse is controlling what would be the right thumbstick, you need to balance your mouse sensitivity with your right thumbstick sensitivity, so that's in-game you want to toggle that just to get the balance to feel good. However, by default it did still feel extremely good. The mapping that comes with this setup is very, very well done, but it won't make you immune to random gunfire from airplanes. Now I did get on with this very well, I ended up playing the whole match here, and as you can see from the scoreboard, I wasn't absolutely terrible, but I'm still absolutely not perfect either. So although this will allow you to use your mouse and keyboard, unless you play the game quite a lot, you're going to be probably on average as good as a lot of the main controller players in game. Responsiveness though was absolutely perfect. There was, as I said, a little bit of mouse lag feeling without that sensitivity adjustment, but the WASD and using the keyboard commands were absolutely perfect. It just takes a bit of getting used to get your head around the remapped controller buttons to your mouse and keyboard. Overall though, I'm really impressed at how well this works. As you can see, I was even able to pull off some sniper shots, and it makes it so much easier with the mouse and keyboard. So let's dive into how to get this set up. So for this we are using some software called ReWASD, and they also have a guide if you want the text version of how to use your mouse and keyboard for cloud gaming, and I'll put that in the description below. But if you want the video guide, I'm going to run through exactly what you need to do to set up here. So once you've downloaded it, you will have a 14-day trial. If you do want to purchase, it's around $6 or $18 if you want the full package. But obviously try out the free trial to make sure that it's going to do what you want it to. And it is worth noting that if you are using a USB hub, there are some extra steps that you will need to follow, but I do find that it works a lot better if we just use direct input. So I've got my mouse and keyboard input separately here. And then in the interface, we'll see all of the devices down the left-hand side. So we need to identify which one's our mouse and which one's our keyboard. So I can see by the names which one's which, but the program doesn't make the assumption of what it is, so we need to tell it. So I'm going to pick the keyboard, select the keyboard icon and submit that, and then do the same with the mouse icon. And once I've got those two together, I now need to make a group. So I click the little plus by the name there, create a group with the mouse and keyboard. This is essential for this controller setup. Hit the save button and now it's automatically selected my group, which is what I want to keep there. If you do happen to hit the wrong device and hit save when you're doing that setup, you can just go down to the settings cog in the bottom right and hit clear data. This will reset all those device inputs so you can just select the right ones. Now there is a base setup configuration for this so that you don't have to start completely from scratch, and I'll link the file in the description below. So once you've downloaded that config, all you need to do is double click it, and this will start the import process. So you can either give it a new name or use the name that it comes with, which is Xcloud Gaming, which is very useful, and then just hit the import button. This will take you to the mappings, so you can have a look at the keyboard and mouse mappings to see what controller buttons that they've been mapped to, just to familiarize yourself with it. It's quite intuitive once you have a first run through in a game or two, and it really does make a lot of sense the way that this is mapped out, but you can click these and change the mappings if you need to customize it further. You can see the mouse here is set to the right stick, up, down, left and right, and because it's using the mouse movement, you're not going to be scrolling forever, you're just going to be making that small adjustment left, right, up and down. Now if you want this to automatically apply when you start up things like Xbox Cloud Gaming or Chrome for the PC app, then just select the associated apps here, and instead of picking the .exe file, say add active processor, so as long as Chrome's running, you can then just pick Chrome. and this will make sure that when you use the auto detection method that it will apply as soon as you go into the browser. You can see it's not enabled. If I go into Xbox Cloud Gaming, I don't have a controller enabled. And if I manually apply it, you will see that then a controller is detected. It does give you a warning saying that using combo and turbo modes could be considered cheating in competitive games, so they don't promote this as a way of cheating. This is just a way of using your inputs a bit more optimally. So as you can see, now I've hit apply, the controller has been detected as it creates a virtual controller with those mappings. Now I'm locked to using my mouse and keyboard as a controller. By default, to get out of this, you can just hit the Windows key and that will put this shift mode on, which gives me back my mouse and keyboard control. So if I want that to be manual, then it will apply straight away. If I want it to auto detect, I can hit that auto detect in the top right and this target icon. And now as soon as I switch into one of these applications in that list, you'll see I get the notification in the bottom right that it now is automatically applied and my mouse and keyboard is now back into controller mode. And again, to get out of that, I can just hit the Windows key so I can get back to the mappings. So that is about it. Let us know in the comments below if you're going to be trying this out. As I said, it does come with a 14-day trial so that you can test this out. Otherwise, look out for a link in the description. If you do want to purchase, you can do it for as little as $6 or the one-off purchase of $18 for the full package. Have fun playing with mouse and keyboard in Xbox Cloud Gaming. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things cloud gaming. And we will see you next time.